Okay, we'll continue. V is equal to Ks sin 2 theta by 2. So when you substitute the values, you will get it as C is 0, right? So you don't need to substitute for C sin theta. It is 19.95. Okay, now elevation between the instrument axis and A. You know the instrument axis, horizontal axis is this. The elevation between the horizontal axis and A is how much? If you know the V value, we already found V, right? If you know the V value, how can we find the distance between horizontal axis and A? This small distance, how can we find? V minus central reading, right? So when we deduct the central reading from total V, you will get this elevation, right? Isn't it? So you can find that also, elevation between instrument horizontal axis and A is equal to V minus central reading of A, which is equal to V minus 1.915 or 19.95 minus 1.915, and the value is 18.035. Okay, now you can find the readings corresponds to observation from P to B. So next is observations from P to B. Again, angle theta is 5 degrees 6 minutes. Staff intercept S is upper reading minus lower reading, that is 2.705 minus 1.065, and the value is 1.64. Okay, so while substituting in the equation, you can find D. D is Ks cos square theta, which is equal to 162.7, and V is Ks sin 2 theta by 2, and when you substitute the values, it is 14.52. Okay, again, you found the V value. You need to get the elevation between the horizontal axis and B, the small distance. Okay, how can we find that? The small distance from the horizontal axis to the point B. So for that, you can deduct the central reading from V, right? So elevation between horizontal axis and B it is V minus central reading of B equal to 14.52 minus 1.885. You will get it as 12.635. Okay, so it's clear to you, right? So we calculated the horizontal distance from P to A, P to B, and we also calculated the elevation of A from horizontal axis, elevation of B from horizontal axis. Okay, so from these two values, like elevation between the horizontal axis and B and elevation between the horizontal axis and A, using that two values, you can find the elevation difference between A and B. The elevation difference between A and B. Okay, so how can we find that? Elevation difference between A and B, which is equal to 18.035 minus 12.635. It is 5.4. Okay. Now, what is gradient? Gradient between A and B means gradient between A and B is equal to, or gradient between A to B is equal to, the elevation between A and B divided by the distance AB, right? Elevation between A and B divided by the distance AB. Okay, now the elevation between A and B we already found. How? So this was the profile BA. From the horizontal axis, you know this elevation, you know this elevation. Okay, when you deduct these two values, you will get the elevation difference between A and B. That is what we have found here. Elevation between A and B. Okay. Now the distance AB. You need to calculate the distance AB. So I already draw the profile. This is P, 90 degrees. This is A. This is B. From observation P to A, you calculated the distance, right? That is 107.29. And from the observation P to B, you calculated the distance PB. Distance PB, that is 162.7. Okay. Since it is a right angle to triangle, you can find the distance AB, right? Distance AB equal to root of 162.7 square plus 107.29 square. You will get it as 194.89. Now you got the elevation between A and B from here. You got the distance AB. And you substitute these two values. That is 5.4 divided by 194.89, you will get the value as 0.0277. Okay, so every time we represent the gradient as 1 in x, so represent it as 1 in x and get the value of x, you will get it as 1 in 36.099. So the answer is gradient from A to B is equal to 1 in 36.099. Okay, hope it's clear to you.